Well, I have to start that one again because it looks like I'm searching for nice things to say. we'll start again. Well, it's all a new job. And, you know, I'm a jobbing actress. I'm used to moving from one job to the next and meeting your new family that you're going to be working really closely with. And that's how I'm a team player. And that's how I like to feel when I'm in my new group of actors with a new job, is that this is like your little family. And there wasn't one person that you just thought, oh, God, that's going to be, he's going to be a problem or she's going to be a pain. There wasn't... They might have thought that about me, but I didn't think that about them. And no, it was they were all a joy to work with. Really lovely people, genuinely lovely people. Vic McGuire, obviously, I'd seen him in Bread. Nicholas, I'd watched since I was a little girl. Butterflies. I remember one of my first TV crushes was the guy who plays his dad. Not Nicholas, but obviously, so I remember Nicholas's work from that. And obviously he never stops. So there was Vic and Nicholas. Chris Ettridge, didn't really know much about him. He was so lovely to work with, very funny as well. And Emma, I didn't know until we met working on the show. Well, what was interesting was at the end of my second series, there was a song written for Phoebe, and they didn't know whether I could sing or not. I suppose they thought it didn't really matter as long as I could kind of hold a tune or whatever. And I really enjoyed singing this song. And I said to the writers, you know, it would be really lovely if, you know, if Phoebe could do some more singing, if we could kind of find a premise for her to do some more. You know, all those lovely ballads and stuff from the 40s. When I got the scripts for my third series, Phoebe had become this nightclub singer. Gary buys her this nightclub and she is she's the singer. Oh, and I got to wear the best frocks and sing lovely songs nearly every week. And that was great to be able to suggest that. And then instead of going, yes, yes, whatever, they actually took me up on that, so that was great.
Blue moon, you saw me standing alone, without a dream in my heart.
Take it on until the war's over, you mean? Before we move to California?
Well, just think it over. Stay and have another look round.
Reggie's leaving, Do. He's out the church hall.
Well, I'll go now. You come along later. Reg won't mind. There'll be plenty of people.
Gary? I suppose I could be the singer, couldn't I?
You? Well, yeah, I suppose you could. Hadn't really thought of that.
Favourite storyline in the show? Which was the episode where Phoebe meets Yvonne in the shop? I can remember that one. And I think she was introduced as Yvonne Goolagong, his head of intelligence or something like that. And the look on his face when the two girls met, that was a good one.
Come on then, let's go home, eh?
Oh, it's chilly out.
Hello.
Hello. I'm Yvonne.
Phoebe, you're Gary's number one, aren't you?
I sincerely hope so.
Love your coat. Very unusual.
I got it in America, Bloomingdale's.
Blooming where?
It's a shop.
Fancy?
Not really.
Pardon?
Sorry.
Fascinating as this conversation is, I really think we should be getting on.
Okay, Commander. Do you want me to put my blindfold back on?
I think I'll go back to the car. Nice meeting you.
Likewise. TTFN.
Did that really just happen?
I think so, yeah. You should probably be running along. God!
Yeah, I'd lap it up. Just to see all the guys again would be lovely. And I think there's certainly room for a nice Christmas special. Yeah, definitely. I'd love to. What year would it be for that? Well, it would be, so we're 7 years on, early 50s. She would probably be releasing a nice new dance band album. And Gary would be looking after the kids like a modern dad. Yeah.
How many kids did you have?
Oh, she'd have knocked a few out by then. Probably about three. What can I tell you about Elizabeth Carling? Well, I'm from Middlesbrough. I started to work professionally when I was 19. But when I was 18, I joined the National Youth Theatre of Great Britain and did a musical of the Scottish play. Interesting. No, it was lovely. It was a great show, actually, and I made lots of new friends. And an agent came to see that show. And it could have been any old Tom, Dick and Harry, but it turned out that she was a really good agent. And she wanted to take me on. And I said, yes, please. And so I had my first professional job when I was 19. And here we are. Years later, and still here. So I must be doing something right. Oh, I can tell you a little bit about Casualty. I play Dr. Selena Donovan, and I've been in the show now for 2 years, and I'll be in it for another year at least. And that's hard work. Hard work with lots of medical jargon that I know not what I'm talking about half the time. As long as I can pronounce it properly and look very efficient, yeah, you know, I can get away with it. But that's another great job. I've been so fortunate in my career to have worked with lovely people and to have done fantastic projects. And this is another one to add to my favourite shows list.